raise money. How do you react to that?
So, once again, we urge Donald Trump to look at the facts, not to make up the facts. Mm. And in fact, if he takes a look at our website, you will see that every dollar raised is actually going into a segregated and dedicated RECOUNt account, so that this money cannot be spent for any purpose other than advancing the RECOUNt.
Woo!
At this point, it doesn't look like there is any possibility that there is going to be money left over, because the price keeps being raised on us. The price of our democracy, which is actually an outrageous concept, that we have to dig deep and come up with millions of dollars to affirm our democracy. Nonetheless, it's very clear there are not going to be dollars left over. We will be lucky if we have enough dollars, and I encourage people to go to jill2016.com/recount to ensure that we can make this very critical exercise in affirming our democracy, that we can make that happen.
Dr. Stein, do you feel like the outcome, though? Because I'm getting mixed messages here. Some people say, this is not about the outcome, this is not about Hillary Clinton, but what I just heard from you is, you think the outcome will be differently in these three states.
Well, I think the outcome will be very different in the minds of Americans. The outcome will be that we have an election system that we can trust. That is our first and foremost intention here, is to verify the vote and ensure that we have a accurate, secure, and fair voting system. Whether it will change the outcome, we don't know, and I think it would be unfair to raise expectations that the outcome is going to change. That's not our intent, and when we identified Michigan as one of the important states to examine, there was no victor at the time, so I want to underscore that we were not challenging one candidate or assisting another candidate. This is about ensuring that all votes get counted and that voters can trust this system going forward. Thank you.
Ma'am, what evidence do you have of specific irregularities, and what proof do you have that those 75,000, I think that's the number you used, are blank? What proof do you have?
So I don't know, Jonathan, do you want to speak to that?
Well, I think there are a number of things that raise tremendous concern in an election.
Answer my question, though. What proof do you have that those 75,000 ballots are blank?
There is no way to determine. We think, compelling circumstantial evidence that machinery that is unreliable and archaic, machinery that has been outlawed in several states because of its unreliability, is operative here. There is no question the federal government, through the FBI and the Department of Homeland Security, has confirmed that we have had an unprecedented level of cyber attack and cyber intrusion. There have been cyber attacks on the voting systems in Arizona and Illinois. Voting files were seized. 20 other states were the victims of other attempts to intrude and hack this election. The Democratic National Headquarters was intruded, and the verification process is something contemplated by our democracy. We are not engaged in a crazy, radical, undemocratic process. We are taking advantage of the mechanisms in every state that are supposed to allow us to explore when the most important election in this country could have been compromised. So anyone who's opposed to this, and the person who owns that building behind us, is involved in an anti-verification campaign, in a let's sweep it under the rug campaign, in a let's hide it. And we are not going to surrender to that, because the essence of a democracy is grounded in the vote, in the awareness that every vote counts. Votes matter. We have mechanisms to ensure it. We have checks and balances throughout this system.